Hi! If you were among those who requested a glitch transition tutorial for Fortnite, we heard you. In today's video, we'll show you how to do just that. If you're ready to get started, let's do this. Switch your workspace to Prime and add source files to the resource window. In our case, it's the Fortnite footage and the background music. First, let's add the background music to the timeline, because you'll need to find the right moment for the transition. Once you find it, create a marker. Next, add your Fortnite footage and find a moment where you defeat your enemy. Create another marker. Synchronize the audio and video files by aligning the markers. Select both files and convert them into a sprite with the following parameters. Uses container no, show effects yes, fill background no. Open the sprite and type hue in the template window. Now that the hue saturation lightness effect has popped up, add it to the scene and set its duration to 2 seconds. For this effect, we only want to keep warm color tones in the video. To achieve this, on the color spectrum, create control points for the red and purple parts, and then drag the cool tones closer to the center of the spectrum to minimize them. We also want the colors to fade out gradually. To achieve that, find transparency, switch to linear parameter change, and type 0/100. Go back to the template window and type lens, then drag the lens distortion effect to the scene. Set its duration, 1 second. Then shift the block to the right and align it with the rest. In the properties window, find distortion factor, switch to linear parameter change and type 0/1. Add a glitch effect to the scene and set its duration at 0.5 seconds. In the Properties window, find Presets and select Colors Only. Then find Transparency, Linear Parameter Change, 0/100. Find the Brightness Contrast Gamma effect and add it to the scene. Since we want to make the image kind of fade out and recover gradually, we'll need to use the Linear Parameter Change again. So place the timeline playhead around the first frame of the fragment, then find contrast levels and type 0/18. Find gamma levels and type 0/-45. And that was the first part of the transition, okay? Let's move on to the second part now. Duplicate the brightness contrast gamma effect and shift it to the right from the marker. We are working on the image recovery now, so place the playhead somewhere around the first frame of this piece and set the following parameters. Brightness, linear parameter change, -26, 0. Contrast levels, linear parameter change, 7, 0. Gamma levels, linear parameter change, 20, 0. Finally, add the broken TV effect to the scene. Find scrolling step, switch to linear parameter change and type 200, 0. Okay, let's wrap this up. For each effect in the Object Drawing Duration and Object Creation Time tabs, find Lock to Parent Duration and select No. Then select both effects on the timeline and hit the plus sign in the Templates window to save them as a new effect template. Right mouse click the new effect and check the box in front of the Use Template Duration parameter to save the effect duration. Now check this out. You can add a new video to the scene and apply the template, just like that. We hope you liked this tutorial, and if you did, go ahead and hit the thumbs up or leave a comment below. We'd love to hear your thoughts. Until next time.